So what I'm going to be talking about today is an example of how you can migrate from IBM Integration Bus version 10 into App Connect Enterprise version 11. Both of those were referring to software deliveries from IBM. What I'm showing on this chart on the left side is an example of an IBM Integration Bus version 10 system. And the first stage in a migration is a decision point whether you wish to migrate one flow at a time or whether you wish to migrate your whole estate all at the same time. If you were to do things one step at a time, you would take a branch in version control, and then you would deploy your artifacts from the version 11 toolkit into the version 11 runtime. An alternative to that is what we sometimes refer to as the Big Bang approach. And what this would involve doing is taking a backup of your existing IBM Integration Bus version 10 deployment using the MQSI backup broker command. That will generate for you a zip file, which can then either be used on the same machine or moved to a different physical machine where you have App Connect Enterprise version 11 installed. With this backup zip file, you can then run the MQSI extract components command. It's the job of this command to take information from that zip file and generate the artifacts that are required by version 11 for placement on its file system into a working directory. These artifacts can be placed under a standalone integration server working directory, or alternatively into server directories for the use of servers which are owned by an integration node. So that's a summary of what we're going to see then, that second method of using the MQSI extract components command, and for that we'll switch to a different set of views. So what we're viewing here is an integration command console at version 10. The MQSI service command shows I've happened to choose FixPack 15 here. And if I do a listing, we will see that we have a single integration node defined on this system called migration example. If I list that migration example node, you'll see I have three servers, server 1, 2, and 3. Looking at the web user interface, we'll also get a view of those three servers and what has been deployed to them. In the first, we have an example of an application. That application has a flow, and if we move to the second server, you'll see we have deployed here a REST API. It happens to use a shared library, and in the third server, we have an example of an integration service. So a few different artifacts. We also have some configurable services defined on this system. Here's an example of an activity log configurable service. You can view services both through that web UI, but also from the command line. So if we issue a report properties command against that same integration node, we can see an example of an SAP configurable service as well. This has many different properties associated with it, but one in particular that's going to be easy to pick out once we've done our migration is the gateway host property. The first step to migrate is to stop your existing running integration node. The MQSI stop command will bring migration example to a halt, and then we will issue the next command, which is doing a backup of the existing broker. MQSI backup broker migration example, we provide a directory structure, and into this place we will generate a zip file which has inside of it all of the state from the existing IB version 10 system. Having nominated this directory, we'll check that the command is successful by navigating to the directory in my Windows Explorer session. We can see the zip file is there. Everything's run successfully so far. Now we'll move to a different coloured command console. The blue characters here denote the fact this is in App Connect Enterprise version 11, and to begin with, no integration nodes are available on this new system. We can run the extract components command using the backup file that we've just generated. So this is pointing the next parameter back to the zip file at the same disk location where we generated it a moment ago. The next parameters specify the name of a source integration node, which will be taken from within that backup. We can also specify a target integration node name, which will be generated as our new integration node on version 11. We've chosen a deliberately different name here, acev11_migrated. The command will fly past a lot of different input there, telling us about the various properties that are available between the two different systems. You can always look at that later for a more detailed peek at what has happened. Now the node is available. We can start it up with the MQSI start command. And if we go back to our web browser session on the same port that was previously configured for version 10, we now have access to the App Connect Enterprise version 11 web user interface. Here we have the same three servers that we saw before, with the artifacts underneath them, an example of an application. In the case of server 2, we have an example of a REST API. The shared library has been migrated as well. On the policies tab, we also now see the policies which are the version 11 equivalents of the configurable service. And sure enough, in the SAP configurable service, we now have that gateway host property that's come through successfully. So in summary, a very trivial example, but it shows a successful migration between IBM Integration Bus version 10 and AppConnect Enterprise version 11.